All right, hello everyone. So today I am going to go over Facebook sharing or Facebook privacy. So this is going to go over how to make things shareable, both as your default and post by post. So next, so I'll start by explaining what it means for a post to be public. Then I'll go over how to set your defaults. Then I'm going to go over changing the audience for a single post, and then setting up a custom audience that you can use as a template over and over again. Okay, so before we dive into these screenshots, what makes the difference between the public post and any other kind of audience is a public post is public. So anyone is eligible to see it so long as it is showing up somehow in their feed. So if it's public, that means that it can be shared. And that means that if I were to share somebody else's public post, then anyone that sees it on my feed can share it. If it's public, it can go viral. However, if it's something that's not public, friends of friends, that audience is still gonna be limited. People won't be able to share it. They'll only be able to see it within that limited spectrum of the friends of your friends. So you wouldn't be able to, it's not an infinite friend sequence that just like goes on and on and on. So if you want something to be shareable so that it can get out as far as you want it to, as far as possible, then make sure that it's public. So now I'm gonna go into the defaults. So I've got some screenshots here on the screen, which you can see. If you go, you're going to want to go on the web version because it's got more of the options available and it's a lot easier to navigate when you're going to go and update settings. So at the top, at the top right, you'll see your avatar, the little grid, the messenger, the notifications, and then the little arrow. So you'll click on the arrow. In the dropdown, you're going to choose settings and privacy. Then after that, you're going to click on settings again, and then you're going to click on privacy. Now, after you click on privacy, you're going to get the privacy settings page. And you're going to start off at the top left in the privacy defaults. These are just like the generic settings. And on this page, since we're specifically targeting making posts shareable and who's able to comment and be able to like and all of that jazz, I have selected and squared off a couple of the settings that we're going to want to pay attention to most. So on this generic privacy settings page, you're going to want to look at under your activity, who can see your future posts. Now this is the default. So currently mine was set to public when I had this screenshot taken. So by default, when I go to post, public is going to be the audience that's selected, which means all of my posts by default are going to be shareable. And you can click on the edit to change that to any of the other options like friends of friends, or if you have a custom audience, you can select that, or you can just make it so that by default, only yourself can see it. Okay, so now we're going to go down on the left panel from the privacy defaults to profile and tagging. So now once you're on this page, you're going to see under viewing and sharing, there's an option that says allow others to share your posts to their stories. So what this means is the stories are, they're the portrait mode videos that will play either when you're on the home screen, you'll see a couple of recent stories listed at the top that people have added. And then you can also see it when you click on their avatar. It's kind of like with Instagram. So when you have this set to on, what someone can do is if they have something to add on to a post that you've made, or if they just want to promote you, if they were at an event that you just posted about, they can share that to their story. So the stories can be videos or they can be photos. So when they share that, anyone who's watching their feed and their stories will be able to see your post. So it is important to have that on if you want people to be able to do that. Next is tagging. So who can see posts you're tagged in on your profile? So now there is this option down here to keep in mind when you are setting these for reviewing. So you can make it so that you can review these posts before people can see what you're tagged in, but regardless of whether you're reviewing it or not, who do you want to be able to see these posts that you're tagged in? So for our office, we tag you in posts where we are congratulating you or when we're telling you that you won an award, so that you don't have to post it yourself. If you're concerned about coming off like you are speaking very highly of yourself, or if you're concerned about being salesy or bragging or anything like that, then that's it makes it easier if it just shows up after we've tagged you. Like, we're doing a shout out to you. Hey, you won this thing. Great job. Keep up the good work. So you want to make sure that other people can see that. So you want to make sure that it doesn't say only me, which is currently what mine was set to. So you would want to make sure that your friends and even the public can see that. So choose whatever the most public version of the options is. Then the next one is, when you're tagged in a post, who do you want to add to the audience of the post if they can't already see it? So if we were to post something, which we will always post something as public as possible because we want to promote you guys, but if we were to post something to the office group congratulating you and we have the audience as the office members, then you can, through this, extend the audience to more people. So if it's only got everybody who's a part of ROGA, Realty One Group Advisors, then you can, through this selection, add public or all of your friends to be able to see that you've just been congratulated for an award. Then under reviewing, the next one, review posts you've tagged in before the post appears on your profile. So if you've got our posts, which should always be professional, but you've also got some other friends that will tag you in some questionable things that you don't really want to appear on your profile. If you have another job that's a lot more stringent and strict about what shows up on your profile and you don't want any questions to be asked about, like why there's alcohol in a photo or something like that, then you can put review on, so that even if you do want it to be displayed on your wall when you're tagged, you have the opportunity to review every post that you're tagged in so that you can say no if one of them happens to not be to your liking. Then you have this option here, review what other people see on your profile. This is not a setting as a default. This is just an option. If you want to see what the public can see on your profile page, you can click this view as, and it's going to show you what your profile would look like to someone else who's not your friend yet. So you can click view as, and you're viewing it as a member of the public community. Okay, so the last one on this page is review tags people add to your post before tags appear on Facebook. So if you were to have somebody try and tag one of your posts with something like, maybe they were trying to help you out to expand your audience, maybe you didn't use all 30 tags that you can use, and so they were trying to help give you a boost by sharing it with more people that are searching for more search terms. However, maybe you want to be able to have a chance to see what those tags are. So if somebody tags something that seems unrelated, or if they tag it with a typo and you don't want to be seen as someone that makes typos, then you might want to be able to review those tags first. So that's what the last one is. So now moving on to the next page is public posts. So now for public posts, the first one is who can follow me. So you don't actually have to be someone's friend on Facebook in order to follow them. So you can get the updates, see all of their public posts in your feed without being friends with them. So that can be really useful, let's say, for an acquaintance or someone that you're not quite close enough to want to, like, maybe you've never met them in person, but you want to see their public posts because you're interested in their business and some of the information that they have, then you can follow them without actually friending them. So you want to make sure that as a business owner, that you have this set to more than just your friends, so that more than just your friends can follow you, so that the public can, so that they can see anything that you post about your business if you're using your personal Facebook for that. Next is public post comments. Who can comment on your public post? So you want to make sure that if you're posting something for the public, that you're not posting it and being like, hey, look at this thing that's great that you might want to comment on because it's fantastic and it might elicit a response from you, and then block them from commenting because that might create a negative reaction because somebody might want to say something, or they might want to tag a person in the comments and then they can't do that because they can't comment on it. So you definitely want to make it so that the public can comment on it. Then for public post notifications, get notifications from public posts. So you can change who you get notifications from. So let's say you have a post that goes viral, you might not want to have 1,000 notifications from every single person that liked and commented on your post. But while you're still growing and you haven't quite gotten there, you might want to see that. You might want to be able to engage with the public. So you might want those notifications. Public profile info, who can like or comment on your profile pictures and other profile info. So for mine, it's set to friends, but you can adjust that to other people. You can adjust it to public. So if, for instance, they want to comment on your job title as a real estate agent, then if you have this set to public, then they'll be able to comment and be like, oh, you're a real estate agent. I would love to work with you. So that you might want to update. And then off Facebook previews. So if you are copying a post to another website and it has the ability to show a preview, then you would probably want to have this turned on, because if you have the preview display with an image, it's going to be more engaging and you're more likely to get someone clicking on it. Okay, moving on. So now I'm going to talk about updating a single post. So let's say that you have your default set to friends, because normally it's personal information that you're posting, and it's only on occasion that you want to post something about your business. So then when you go to create a post and you click this little drop down here that's right beneath your name, this is the audience drop down. When you click on that, you're going to see all of the audience options that you can select. So public, anyone on or off Facebook can see this post if it shows up for them in their search results. Friends, friends except, you can exclude some people, only me, specific friends, custom, and any custom list that you have created as a template. So if you only want to show it to certain people, maybe it's something that you just want the office members to see, then you can select only those people. Do keep in mind that if you select it and change it, it will stick with that until you change it back, because it will think that you are potentially changing up what you want to do going forwards, and that maybe you'll have several posts in a row. So do be mindful that if you change it from whatever your default is to something else, you will need to change it back. Otherwise, it will repeatedly do whatever you've updated it to. Moving on to creating a custom audience, which this is our last topic. So this is definitely slightly more advanced and not as necessary. You probably won't need this, but if you want to, for instance, set up a custom group of people that you want to inform with updates, like for instance, if you want to talk to, post something that is specifically for your office coworkers, like all the other real estate agents that you know, you can create a custom list by going to friends and then at the bottom clicking on custom list and then going to the bottom and clicking create list and then selecting the people you want. So you could create a list of everybody that's a real estate agent, and then maybe down the line you want to create a post that talks about a broker open, or maybe you want to create a list that's specifically Realty One Group Advisors members, and then you can post something about something related to the office. So maybe you're going to have some collection of goods available that's physically in the office that you want to let people know that they can come inside and pick up. And then you would want to just really let us know, because you may not want to have everybody in the world that you know that's on Facebook coming into the office. But you know, it's really up to you. So again, that's the last topic. So I just want to say thank you for anyone that tuned in and watched. And I hope you guys have a lovely weekend. And I will talk to you next time. Bye.